Please stand.
Sue.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all to be here this morning to pray together and to pay our last respect to Dianne. We all got to know her. And in the 80 years, there's a lot of good things that she has done for us and for people around her, and even people who are not here today. So we give thanks to God for that life, beautiful life. And perhaps you have been done, I mean, she has done good things for you, and now it is your turn to do good things for others. All the love and kindness and care that you have received. So, together with give thanks to God, we pray for one another too, to be good disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. This world needs it, need you, need all of us. And I invite Deacon John too. He has good connection with the family, with Dianne. So, just so you know, thank you for being here. My sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Dianne to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now sit down and listen to the word of God attentively, beginning with the first reading.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for what? War, and a time for peace. What gain have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. The word of the Lord.
I believe, I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I believe, I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the my light. The Lord is my rock, my salvation. The Lord is my refuge, guarding my life. Of whom should I be afraid? I believe, I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Only one thing I ask, may I live in the house of my Lord. I shall gaze on God's goodness all of my days. I shall live in the shelter of God. I believe, I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I believe I shall see the goodness of God in the land of the living. Be strong, wait for the Lord. I believe, I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land, in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, our citizenship is in heaven, and it is from there that we are expecting a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will transform the body of our humiliation, that it may be conformed to the body of his glory, by the power that also enables him to make all things subject to himself. The word of the Lord.
Keep faithful, for your faithfulness I will give you the crown of life. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, we gather together today to give thanks and praise to God for the life and work of Dianne, a special person. This is also our way of saying thanks to Dianne for having shared her life with us, with family and friends, and our parish. A funeral is our last act of love. the time we as a family share our love for the one who has gone before us back to our Creator. A funeral is also giving Dianne back to God in the spirit of sacrifice. It is only in the context of our Lord's passion and death, which we will celebrate this coming Holy Week, that we can penetrate the mystery of suffering and understand the real meaning of the word sacrifice. We are called on to make so many sacrifices during our lifetime, but the loss of a dear one is the supreme sacrifice. Dianne is now a spirit, and we will learn to relate to her in a new way, as Jesus' disciples did after he left earth to go to his Father. After a life well lived, Dianne passed on to the Lord at the age of 80. And we are here this morning to celebrate Dianne's life with her family. Dianne, in the words of her obituary, was an active member of several liturgy committees of two Catholic parishes, St. Dominic Savio in Edmonton and St. Gerard right here in Calgary. She loved to share her artistic design and crafting skills, decorating churches for weddings and other milestone celebrations. Dianne watched the Mass on TV every day. She must have enjoyed her occasional spiritual retreats at Mount St. Francis Retreat Center. And this is why she had a special relationship with its staff. And she was the eldest of seven children, and she was 4 months older than her aunt Lorna, and they were raised together in Bodo like sisters, as Dianne's dad was overseas with the Loyal Edmonton Regiment. Watching her nieces and nephews grow up was a source of joy to Dianne. She offered her lending hand to provide before and after school care. The first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes states the fact that there is a season for everything under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. For Dianne, her allotted time on earth is now over, and she died in the warm embrace of God. There is no better place we could hope to go to when we die than in the arms of God. It's a beautiful way to describe God's loving care for us. It reminds us of when we were toddlers and our parents held us in their arms. We are in the arms of God. Imagine passing from this earth with all our pain and troubles, and in the next second being taken up into God's outstretched arms. We have absolutely nothing to fear. We believe that God has taken Dianne up into his arms. Dianne's death is not the end of her life. She is alive with God. Her citizenship is in heaven. She is changed not ended. We can still be close to her and she close to us. We can pray for her and she will be close to us by praying for us. We may forget her, but she will never forget us. Our Lord Jesus has shown us that this life and the next life are joined by his own death and resurrection. Yes, Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. He is the only way. In fact, he is the only one we need. It's not anything we do. It's what he has done for us. God is all merciful. God does not make a judgment of us based on only one part of our life. God makes a judgment of us based on all of our life. God has seen good works in Dianne and will reward her for it. Her death breaks our hearts, but we trust in God and leave her now in God's hands, knowing with God's help, we will all be reunited with God and with Dianne. Every funeral mass is an act of remembering, gratefully, a life which has been an unfolding of the providence of God. We bless and thank God for all that Dianne was and entrusted her soul to the Lord. May she rest in peace. And let us together keep in our hearts the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, a great promise. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. And believe with all our hearts that that is where Dianne has gone. Let us now stand for the prayer of the faithful. My dear friends in Christ, let us join with one another in praying to God, not only for our departed sister, but also for the church, for peace in the world, and for ourselves.
For all of us gathered here today, that a firm hope of resurrection fill our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people who mourn, that they find consolation and peace in God through the people in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Dianne and for all who have died today, that they enjoy the full presence of God amongst family and friends who have gone before them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Dianne, that they experience the strength of our faith in Christ in the midst of church community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each one of us, that we remember our sister Dianne and the good effect she has had on our life, and that we incorporate those good things into our relationship with others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, Creator and Redeemer of all the faithful, grant to the souls of your departed servants release from all their sins. Hear our prayers for those we love and give them the pardon they had always desired. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
This is the light of new beginnings. This is the night when heavens meet earth. This is the night filled with God's glory, promise of our new birth. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. This is the night. Rose from the grave, triumphant and free, leaving the tomb of evil and darkness empty for all to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Now will the fire kindled in darkness burn to dispel the shadows of night. Star of the morning, Jesus our Savior, you are the world's true light. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for good and the good of all his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Dianne, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your holy will that we are governed, and at your command that we return to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created right to give you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give light to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Gerard and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and William McGrattan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Dianne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. But deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in a shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you. Shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Please stand. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Dianne, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our last farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Dianne shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Dianne, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory.
Softly and tenderly Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. See, on the portals he's waiting and watching, watching for you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Dianne in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Dianne in this life. They are signs of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace and in the sure hope of the resurrection, we take leave of the remains of our sister, knowing that one day we shall be with her in heaven. That is the conclusion of the funeral mass today. On behalf of Dianne and her family, thank you all for your love you've shown today and all your prayers. Following the funeral mass, we will, after this recession, we will sit down for the eulogy here. And then after the eulogy, you're welcome to go to the hall, turn to the right, to the hall for reception. And I believe there's a video there too to be shown. Thank you all once again.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord, for God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled, and the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness can fill, for I say they shall be satisfied. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today, and lead me, Lord,
Good morning, everyone. Still morning. Hi, my name is Richard, and I'm here to share a few words about my sister-in-law, Dianne. When my wife, Lori, and I learned of Dianne's passing on March 20th, a couple of thoughts flashed through my mind. First of all, it was a Sunday, and Dianne faithfully attended Mass, often almost daily due to it being televised. We're not sure, but perhaps she was able to watch it the day of her passing. Second of all, I recalled that back in 2019, she asked me to do her eulogy. Back then, my wife, Lori, her sister, and I were on a vacation in Calgary. Dianne had been in the hospital for a couple of days, and we wanted to see her. So she took us to a nearby family room, and so over some snacks, of course, tea, coffee, she said, "Here you go, Rich. Try one of these cookies. And by the way, would you like to do my eulogy?" I was like, "Ah, she set me up with a snack." Since it, and what could I say, but of course. Since it had been 3 years and I hadn't been back to Calgary since, I wondered if she remembered that request. What do you think? When Lori and I married in 1989, we, along with Dan and Sherry, had a reception in Calgary for family who couldn't make it to our Los Angeles-based wedding. I got to meet the entire Schaffler family, all five sisters and one brother, their spouses, and also the entire extended Gramlich and Schaffler family. It was quite an event. It was then for the first time that I realized how similar Dianne and her siblings were. Witty, well-spoken, funny, kind, generous, and lovers of all things card and board games, fun and food. Midnight supper, anyone? Dianne embodied all of these traits and more. Dianne regularly checked up on us in Los Angeles with a card, a letter, or a call. If I was the one answering the phone in those pre-cell phone days, Dianne and I would often chat at length before I handed off the phone to Lori. She was friendly, outgoing, creative, and crafty, somewhat adventurous, whimsical, generous, and funny. Regarding creativity, she had the ability to not only envision the ideas for her work, but had the hands-on skill to bring the vision to fruition. Dianne didn't just send you a birthday card. She sent homemade birthday card masterpieces. Many of you may have been a recipient of one of those. I kept some of her birthday cards around far too long because they were just too hard to throw away. Her artistic creativity also overflowed into her spiritual life as she designed countless church banners filled with incredible colors and symbolism that worked into the seasonal themes of Christmas, Lent, Advent, and Easter. The dove, representing peace, of course, was one of her favorite symbols. It could be that perhaps her banners are still being displayed today at churches around Alberta. Regarding the whimsical and adventurous side of Dianne, her sister related a story to me where the two of them were living together in an Edmonton apartment. And being working girls, they were on a tight budget and one night really wanted pumpkin pie and coffee. A pie crust and pumpkin, how difficult could it be? The crust was prepared and the can of pumpkin opened and poured in and baked. They looked forward to their masterpiece, but soon, much to their disappointment, it tasted awful. They soon learned that unprepared pumpkin was not the only ingredient required to make a delicious pumpkin pie. But knowing the two of them, not to be defeated, they abandoned that project and went to a local hotel where they ordered the pie and coffee and relished the moment together. Dianne loved young people, whether nieces, nephews, or neighborhood children. She had a way of making them feel special and important. I recall one occasion about 20 years ago when she and Al visited us in Southern California, taking us and our sons, at that time 6 and 8 years old, to a place called Legoland. Our six-year-old, at that time, special needs son Evan, was a huge Darth Vader fan of Star Wars fame, in case you don't know. Darth Vader probably stands about this tall, and Evan at that time about this tall. On that day, we didn't know that Darth Vader himself was actually roaming the park as advertisement for a new Star Wars Lego display. Evan, of course, was ready with his lightsaber, little toy, as we walked around the park, when suddenly Darth Vader himself was standing right behind Evan. And the two then had a mock lightsaber duel. Now you can imagine that, huge, tall Darth Vader, little tiny Evan, lightsaber duel. Now I mention all that because I looked over, and not only was the look of awe and wonder on Evan's face, because here was Darth Vader, but I noticed Diane's sitting off to the side, and I saw the smile on her face and the twinkle in her eye. And I half wondered at that time if she had arranged for Darth to have this encounter with Evan. I can see it now. Diane wasn't that tall either. Mr. Vader, I have these delicious cookies here. And I was just wondering if you'd mind doing this one small favor for me. On a more recent visit here to Calgary, Diane spent time with our son, Evan, as we, along with several family members, headed out snowshoeing for the day. Evan and Diane spent the day watching old movies, listening to music, playing board games, eating and having junk food. Twizzlers again, Auntie Diane? Diane loved her candy and pop. She also enjoyed crossword puzzles, playing Scrabble, and trying out new technologies like the computer, Facebook, Signal, and WhatsApp. Thank you, sisters, brother-in-laws, for getting her set up on those things and teaching her how to use them. She even learned how to catch an Uber. She enjoyed comedy. She loved to tell a joke or laugh at one, and she even laughed at my bad puns. Diane appreciated the people in her life who assisted her along the way in life's journey. In recent years, she would make her home and healthcare workers feel like part of the family. Also, since she didn't drive, some of her condo neighbors would pitch in to assist her with her errands, like grocery shopping, appointments, and general check-ins to see how she was doing. Her doctors and pharmacists were important to her as well, helping her manage some of the lifelong health issues that she had. From all of us family members, thank you all for supporting, assisting, and caring for Diane. One final memory of Diane that stood out to a few family members was the way she would sometimes share the peace blessing during Mass. Instead of the traditional shaking hands and saying the words, "Peace be with you," with a mischievous grin, she would turn to them, making a double-handed peace sign, and say the peace blessing. And so, Diane, as we say farewell, may you rest in peace.